In this video, I'm going to show how to connect overloaded signals and slots. Let's just keep what we left last time. And we have an officer. Let's say we have a, let's remove this part. Forget the disconnect. If you're interested about the disconnections, go to my another video. Here I'm going to make this code more clear. We have one officer. This officer has a send command method which triggers the signals, emit the signals here. This I'm going to comment here inside emit command signal. And we have this signal and we have a soldier. The soldier will receive the command and going to do something, just pretend command received. And we have an officer. Officer is send command, like I said, emit command. In the officer, we have this soldier object and then connect this officer and soldier and implement here. So what we have this signal and we want our signal being overloaded. Let's say we want to send a message here and we are going to just make another one. Send command, let's say one. And we have signal command. Let's make this command, officer command. Here, Q string command one, command one. So we call this method and these signals we emit with a parameter Q string C1 will be sent, and our receiver of course supposed to receive this. It's also called receive command. The same name overload and q string, and then we just simply receive this and we have to implement this too. Okay, here q string command one, and let's just command received. What's the command? C1. Okay. So we have. In that case, this won't work. No matching, blah, blah, blah. No overload of CMD matching. So this doesn't work. So here is basically some basic C++ knowledge. You have to pass exactly the address of your signal and slot address. So we have to get the pointer of that. Let's say we have our what's the signal? Yes, our signal address. We're going to rename it called CMD 0, which means no parameter, which is this one here. And of course our soldier has also receive command 0, receive nothing, and we get the address of our. In this case, we specify that this to address, the address of the signal is that the signal didn't have a parameter. And then like this, we have CMDB 0 and the receiver is okay. In this case, we only connect officer C. We only connect this one, just what we did before we created overloaded signals and slots. And here we can connect this first two here. Here, which is in this case, this one is not implemented yet. But of course, we are going to let's first see how it looks. We have our main, we create, we do something like this, and we run it. Okay, it's not the member of soldier. This one. Okay, here I have something wrong. One mistake. As always. Sorry for that. Send command one to identify different methods. I just want to override the signal. I don't want to override our normal method because it's not the topic we are talking about. So let's say this is what we expected just like before we created the overloaded signal and slots. Okay, now we want to also that when we want to transport, we want this connection also like overloaded, let's say, and this one, we just copy this, and here, we have this, this time I'm going to connect another signal and slot, which transparent one parameter, transmit one parameter, sorry, forgive my English. And here we connect these two, the same object sender, same object receiver, but different signals, which is overloaded. Here, we are going to call it send command one, this message, let's call hello. Okay, let's say run 10 kilometer, and say run, see how it looks like. Yeah, that's what we expected. This is send this command one. I'm going to go through again. Send command one here. It's going to trigger the command signal with one parameter, and the receiver here is going to receive this parameter and going to print command received and the related string. That's what happened. And I call twice. As I mentioned, this just normal methods of officer, and but under these methods, they are have the overloaded signals, you know, different signals will be triggered. So to make it more interesting, I'm going to make another one. Just see how it looks like. because this time I'm going to only create another overloaded command, which is, and here just no more method. I'm going to call it two, and this one is going to ingest here. Here, this is Q string C two. Here is, we have, let's say, we are going to connect one signal with parameter one to a slot receive. Which has only one parameter. Okay, and we are going to see here officers and push up and say run 10 kilometer. Okay, and let's see the results. Another arrow, interesting. It's a problem. Okay, it's quite interesting because we already specified this here. In that case, run. Okay, this is what we got. Let's see, something is not exactly what I expected. C1 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 C2, so we officer, we connect this command 2 to soldier 1. Okay, here, that's the problem. We are going to connect the signal with two parameters to the slot, which is here, with one parameter, and see the result. See? So the signal send two parameters and the receiver receive only the first parameter. In that case, means the signal can have more parameters, and the slot, the receiver slot, can have less parameter, and their data type have to be the same. And that's it. And I'm going to draw something to explain it well. Okay, what we programmed. In this example, in the main entry point, we had our object officer. And we just, let's see, the constructor, and this constructor connects the officer's command, which is a different implementation of say P1, P2. This all three are signals. I'm going to do it like this. They are signals, and they are all connected to our soldier object. This object is created on the officer in constructor, so we connect the receiver slot, receive command, and another receive command. Let's say receive parameter, only one parameter. Okay, we connect this to this, and this to this, and this to this. That's what we did in the program. And then that's we just connect them in the constructor, and then on the main we just call the functions officer. What's a method? We call command, send command. Send command, and then send command 1, 2, and all these connections are realized by the Qt framework. So what we just do is just call these connect functions to connect different signals and the slots. And as mentioned here, we are talking about signal. Here is the number of parameter is always larger or equal to the number of parameter in slot. And their data type have to be the same, at least. For example, here is P1, P2, and here we have here P1. Their data type have to be the same data type. Yeah, that's what we did here. And I hope you guys get what I mean, and leave any comment. If you still have any questions, I will try my best to answer any questions you drop. And thanks for watching.